Yo, what's up, school fans, and welcome back to the vlog. And we are here for the biggest game this weekend and probably the most anticipated matchup. Udah lama banget kita nungguin, yaitu game antara Dewa United Banten lawan Pelita Jaya Bakri. Dua winning streak is on the line tonight. Kita tahu Dewa still undefeated, 12-0 sekarang ini, the only team di IBL yang masih undefeated. Sedangkan Pelita Jaya lagi on a hot streak, mereka lagi tahan game winning streak. Jadi kira-kira winning streaknya siapa nih guys yang akan putus malam ini nih? So I'm very excited about tonight. Walaupun memang sayangnya gak ada Anthony Bean, gak ada T-Rob, malah gue nungguin banget Anthony Bean lawan Galvin Solano, but it's all good. I think gamenya akan tetap seru banget hari ini. I think we're gonna see a lot of highlights too probably tonight. So guys, once again, just want to say thank you so much for always supporting the vlog. Jangan lupa untuk like. Oh my god, this is my song. This is my song in the background. But once again, thank you so much for always supporting the vlog. Jangan lupa untuk like, jangan lupa untuk comment, and enjoy the vlog, guys.
Wow.
What's good?
What's good? Good luck, bro. Wih, jersey-nya keren juga.
Baik, bro.
Good luck, ya. What up, Jess?
Vario di sini, jambol pasti ke sini, dia yang di sini. Nah, itu ice di situ ya. Kita bicara ya.
Yeah. Get ready for tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
So yeah, we'll see you there probably. Hopefully you'll be there.
Unfortunately, the outcome is not the one that we wanted, but I'm really pleased with the effort that they will have in the game tonight.
Paling ya, selamat buat Pita Jaya. Emang bukan game yang mudah buat kita, tapi game ini yang bakal buat kita lebih baik lagi. Itu aja. Ya, emang sebenarnya hampir semua game intensitasnya hampir sama ya. Cuma emang kebanyakan kita lebih banyak menang jauh. Memang jarang banget kita yang lagi struggle terus. Itu paling sama game hang tua doang kan, tapi kita bisa keluar dari struggle itu. Tapi ya emang ini game inilah yang emang menjadi pelajaran buat kita ke depannya sih.
Caleb had 4 fouls and then you put him back in the third quarter. You feel that was too fast or what was the thinking process?
Yes, I took a gamble. I knew he was in foul trouble and I took a gamble on him, so probably I made a mistake for sure.
And did you see them do anything differently in the second half that makes you guys, your offense kind of stagnant a little bit?
I don't really think it was about offense. I think it was more about defense. We couldn't make stops. They had 37 points in the third quarter alone. They had almost 60 in the second half. So yes, our offense was a little bit stagnant. We relied on ISO a lot. But at the end of the day, we didn't make a lot, because there were a lot of baskets, but we didn't make stops at all. And that allowed them to come back into the game, tie the game, then take the lead. So it was a little bit both sides of the floor, yes.
KJ had a couple of dunks in the fourth quarter. What kind of problem did he give your defense?
The thing that happened was that we were not able to contain a lot on the one-on-one. Mm-hmm. So on the drives, that forced our defense to help, and that...
You had like a 12-game winning streak, undefeated. Were you worried about the players being a little bit complacent?
Well, I have a lot of respect for every opponent. Pritajaya coming from 10-game winning streak. They're gonna play in the finals on BCL. Indonesia, representing Indonesia. Mm-hmm. They have a lot of national team players. They have very good foreigners. I was not afraid. I was really confident about our team. And at the end of the day, even though it's not the outcome we wanted, I'm really at peace with this team, because these guys played their hearts out and showed a lot of resiliency. And for that, I'm going home in peace.
Alright, thank you so much, Coach.
Okay, Head Coach Aham is here. Reza, do you have any comments for today's match, Coach?
Today match is really, really tough game. Today game is a really, really tough game because Dewa United is number one team in the league. They have a good coach, they have a good import also, and the local also there. Yeah, so really, really tough game. Yeah. So I talked to the players that, hey guys, we have to lock in, we have to play as a team. Yeah, but if we coming out and play individually, then they're gonna beat us. So yeah, this is the player like Reza, you know, really active communication inside the court, one of the leaders inside the court. So we can bounce back after we trailing in the second half, right? And then we can seal the game. This is totally team effort. Totally team effort.
Untuk Reza, ada komen untuk pertandingan hari ini?
Ya, kurang lebih sama apa yang Coach Aham bilang. Tough game hari ini. Tapi ya, alhamdulillah kita bisa ambil game hari ini.
Untuk teman-teman media, silakan kalau bertanya.
Coach, hari ini tanpa Anthony Bean, tanpa Thomas Robinson, seberapa banyak perubahan strategi yang harus coach lakukan untuk hari ini?
Sebenarnya it okay, this is the team. So we play without Tiro, we play without Bean, we will play the same level, the same energy there. So this is Pelita Jaya. We try to maintain our level, the way we play in our system. So yeah, a lot of sacrifice coming from the player, you know. Like sometimes I have to put a lot of minutes on them, you know, push them hard, you know. So yeah, this is the team effort. Everybody sacrificed each other, you know, inside the court. But that's the team.
Ketinggalan 17 poin tadi. Quarter dong gini.
Iya.
49-32.
Iya.
Apakah ada adjustment ataupun juga perubahan mungkin dari strateginya coach?
saya bilang ke pemain, ini home game mereka, ini home court mereka, home crowd mereka. So mereka sudah pasti akan familiar dengan ringnya, ya kan? Kita kalau energi kita kurang, effort kita kurang untuk jaga, maka mereka akan wangi terus gitu loh. Jadi ya yang kita boosting di halftime adalah energi, fokus on defense, lebih disiplin sama defense lagi gitu loh, ya kan? Akhirnya ada perubahan datang dari situasi itu gitu.
Komentar tentang defense-nya Agassi jaga Gelvis Solano.
Ya, yeah, you know, Gelvis Solano is the head of the, for me, the head of the snake lah, ya dong. So if we allow Solano to get the ball easy, to bring down the ball easy and create the play, it's really hard. Athletic, good one-on-one skill, good prevision, vision, you know, he can pass the ball, he can shoot. So the thing is, I talk to the player, hey, come on man, we have to put energy there, you have to hustle there, don't allow him to get the ball, okay, put, if he don't get the ball, we are in the good condition. And then, yeah, that's why this is team effort, everybody have to do their own part, you know, Agassi have to do his part to, you know, working hard on deny Solano to get the ball, Reza have to working hard on rebounding, take the shot also, everything, you know, so this is totally team effort.
Okay. Ada nanya? Nah, ya. Okay. Reza, bisa ceritakan dari terakhir apa yang Reza lihat pas passing bolanya ke KJ McDaniels for the dunk at the end?
Tadi sih ya, kalau pas lagi offense itu, kalau saya belajar ya read lawannya aja kayak gimana kan. Dia over deny itu gimana, ternyata dapet lane buat drive. Begitu mau drive, gelap. Ada Prosper, ada siapa saat ini satu lagi? Miller?
Iya, Tavario.
Tavario. Terus, ya udah pas begitu mau naik kan nggak bisa tuh. Langsung KJ-nya dive ke dalam. Ada dua kali lah kayak gitu kalau nggak salah ya. Makanya langsung, wah kosong udah. Karena ya defendernya lompat, udah nggak bisa ngapain lagi. Makanya kalau saya yang naik, saya yang kena kan. Jadi ya udah langsung dapet KJ, to hand it down.
Tapi kok kayak gitu tuh dari latihan atau gimana? Koneksinya bisa tahu KJ itu akan dive gitu.
Kalau di latihan malah lebih seringnya saya jaga-jaganya sama KJ. Karena ya dari coach lah. Kadang suka di ya namanya coaches lah kayak main catur lah ya harus coba gini-gini. Tapi beberapa kali latihan sama KJ dia kalau udah deket bawah-bawah ring itu dia emang sering jemput itu loh, sering dive, sering ini. Jadi, oh bisa dapet momennya kayak gitu pas di lapang ternyata bener aja gitu. Bener aja, kosong.
Kan main gue bilang sama KJ, KJ lu main lawan Borneo cuma 8 kali nembak. Terus dia bilang, oh iya ini gue simpen buat hari ini. Beneran ternyata ya, serius dia 22 kali nembak hari ini. Kalau dari pemain sendiri tadi kan KJ kan seperti sparks ya, seperti yang kasih energi itu bener-bener nular ke semua yang lain.
Ya pastilah, pasti energi positif tuh, energi positif negatif bakal nular ke pemain, ke semua bukan cuma pemain, mungkin ke coaches juga gitu. Jadi Coach Hang selalu ingetin positif energi apapun yang terjadi gitu. Jadi kita harus selalu ngasih yang terbaik, ngasih energi positif biar nyebar gitu, biar energi negatifnya hilang gitu.
Gimana rasanya bisa mematikan 12 game winning streak?
Seneng banget lah pasti gitu. Mereka tim bagus, mereka bahaya gitu, asing-asingnya juga bahaya, tapi Coach Hang selalu bilang start with defense. Apapun yang terjadi, defense dulu gitu. Karena kalau misalnya defense bagus, kita offense pun akan ngikutin lah.
Thank you.
Ya, yeah, thank you.
38 minutes?
Man, I didn't know I was gonna play 38. Man, it was fun. Glad we got the win, man. You know, D-Wild, they had a great home crowd, man, to show support for the team, and they played hard. Especially that first half, man, it was tough for us, but glad we got the win, man.
How big was this window for you guys, you know?
I'm sorry?
How big was this window for you guys?
It's huge, you know, especially later on in the playoffs, hopefully we can get like home court advantage or something like that. So I think it's going to be huge, and it's going to really show towards the end of the season and starting the playoffs.
What do you think about this guy?
Man, he's a beast. He's a beast.
37 points. Man, you know?
So the big.
All the dunks.
Man, that's normal though for him. That's normal, man.
That's all right. Light. All right, guys. Have a good night, guys. I'll see you, Jess.
Thank
appreciate
you, man.
It.
That's the real MVP right there. That's the leader right there. I've been playing JB for what? 3 years? So to have him on the team is good. He teaches me a lot.
But you told me though. You told me yesterday you were saving your shots, man, for tonight.
Yeah, I had to be more aggressive. They're a good team though, man. A credit to them. And the fans they have behind them, they pushed them. So we just got to keep fighting, man. Stay humble. Don't get too high, don't get too low. So that's what we're going to do.
37 points, man.
Yeah, man. Man, I had to. Aggressive team, man. Aggressive offensive team. We had to be aggressive too, so. That's what they bought me here for. You know what I'm saying?
Have a good rest, KJ.
I appreciate it.
What a game, guys. Gila sih. Big respect kepada kedua tim, Dewa United dan juga Pelita Jaya for putting on a show. Gila, itu gamenya benar-benar sesuai ekspektasi kita banget sih. That was really entertaining. Probably one of the best games so far this season. So very lucky sih kita bisa experience itu hari ini. Dan gue juga datang ngeliput, gue seneng banget sih. Jadi, once again, what a game, man. What a game dari down 17 tadi. Akhirnya Pelita Jaya bisa come back. And what a game from KJ McDaniels, man. Itu energinya dia, dunk-dunknya dia. Benar-benar nular banget sih ke teman-temannya untuk hari ini bisa come back. So, once again, what a game, man. I'm very happy, though. Very happy. And this is really good for the league. I think untuk IBL ini keren banget. Like Derek said, ini hype-nya makin naik. And the league is going up, man. The only way is up for the league. So we are very happy. And gue yakin IBL pun juga very happy with this game tonight. And then once again, just want to say thank you so much, guys, for always tuning in for the vlog. Now it's time for me to get some to eat. I'm hungry. And then once again, jangan lupa untuk like, jangan lupa untuk comment. And I will see you guys again in the next IBL game.